here. Right after this, you need to make sure that the grid should be open. That's G. Note that those people who are going to use Cadence never use G. G command is for actually gravity, and it will create other kind of problems. So you will see that. Okay. So please, those people who are using Cadence, do not use G. If they are using G, then one more time they have to press it so that you can avoid that situation. Okay. Here, maybe on top, you might have seen that there is something called DRC. It's called Design for Rule Check. So those design rule for the given technology has been added over here already. So that's by default. Here you can also like guess that this small square should have the dimension of 1 by 1 micrometer, because that's the technology limitation. So 1 by 1 micrometer whole grid is there. Now, if I want to draw any kind of transistor, you know that the poly with both side diffusion will be there. So it's N plus or P plus will decide that whether it's a NMOS or PMOS. Let's assume that you want to make an NMOS. So what you are going to do, you are going to make something called one N plus diffusion, the big strip, and on top of that, you are going to keep something called poly. So if you want to do that, remember that on your mouse, you might have left click and right click. So from where you want to start, you're going to keep the left click. So here you can see that this coordinate of here, there is something is available. So starting from this point where you can see there is some cursor is there. And if I want to take like till here, I need to keep something called right click. Right click. When I'm going to do that, it will create one square. So if I want to have so much big N plus or P plus diffusion, I'm keeping this. And in this box, I'm going to keep, let's assume that I'm making the NMOS. So I'm going to keep, NMOS or PMOS? Or N plus or P plus? From here, somebody can answer. No. For creating an NMOS, what kind of diffusion I need to add, N plus or P plus? For making an NMOS, N plus, right? And here you can see that the everything which is in gray color in grid, it's actually P substrate. Okay, so here when you want to make it, you want to make the N plus. So for that, there are various things are written here. If you go there, something will be written over here. Just note over here that, like, first one is errors, second one labels, third one subcell. So every layers are kept here, like P well, N well, and all these things. So for our case, we want N diffusion, right? So this green color here, again, you can see it's written N diffusion. So if I want to keep that N diffusion in this box, I need to make the scroll, I need to click, or the middle click. If I do that, then it will create that whole thing as N diffusion. Here you can see that the size of this diffusion is 4 by 10 micrometer, right? So that's the dimension of this one. Now, if I want to make, let's say, poly over here, let's say in middle of this one, from here to here. So I'm going with left to right click. Left click was starting the point, and the right click will complete the point. So that is going to make the poly. For that, I need to find out where is the poly. The polysilicon, I'm finding out. Okay. So this one is polysilicon. It's indicated here. So I'm going to make again the middle click or this one. So things are fine. But sometimes, maybe like just for some fun, I can do something just to U is undo, by the way. If I want to make something undo, just for. So here, can you see something extra things over here? Some dotted things are there. So for that, if you're seeing something like this, you need to see here. It's written that DRC equal to 2. Means in design rule check, there is some problem. You can't make such kind of structure. And you need to find out what error is there. For that, you have to write down DRC and then find. So this is the command. Maybe all the commands I'll send you what Rohit has already prepared. So here it's written diffusion must overlap overhang transistor by at least 3. 3 is 3 micrometer. So that's not working here. So what I can do just to fix that, again I draw extra new thing where it's going to be like this. So it's actually going above 4 micrometer. Right? Now it's actually to this side and to this side. So it's enough is available instead of 3. So that was the DRC. So you have to keep looking at this side and to see what kind of errors are coming, you have to find out DRC fine. So that's the thing. Now this NMOS is ready. So backside is, so whole gray side is actually the P substrate. This red color is polysilicon and this green color is equal to N plus diffusion. Now same thing I would like to make for maybe for PMOS. PMOS I am going to keep it on top. So what I'm doing, I'm going to share maybe both the polysilicon together. So I extended this polysilicon and I'm going to keep it in you know, the gate of the PMOS. And similarly for same thing for this one. So for this case, what do we require, Bharat? For the case of PMOS, what kind of P plus? So I need to find out P diffusion. Okay, so P diffusion, where is that P diffusion? It has to be nearby N diffusion. Okay, so this one is P diffusion. After keeping this, so here you can see there is no error. Okay, so DRC is 0. So right now gates are tied together. I'm just giving some name, CMOS something 12. Okay. Is it fine? Okay. And here gates are tied together, and that is what we want in a, in an inverter. Right now I'm making a layout for an inverter. So here what I need is for PMOS, first of all, this is not the complete thing. PMOS is actually inside an N-well. Okay. Right now I'm not making the N-well. I'm going to make the N-well at the end. But before that, what I need is source should be connected to body. So here right now I can see only, you know, 3 connections are there, source, drain and gate. But that bodies are not made. Actually, it's a 4-terminal device, the MOSFET is. So you need to make body for NMOS and body for PMOS. Body for NMOS is known as something called substrate. We need to find out P substrate. So where is it? Which contact? P substrate contact. Okay, so you can take P substrate contact, right? So this will be there. So I'm making some contact. I can make something like that much big of contact. But here you can see there are DRC errors are coming. It shows that you cannot keep so much distance of, you know, this metal. So DRC fine, you can find out that must be separated from this one by at least 4. So from here to here, there has to be 4 micrometers distance. So right now it's 3. So I just made the undo and maybe I can keep somewhere here. With still there is an error. 4. Yeah, because of poly, I think. First of all, it has to be 4x4. That is also the rule, right? Okay, now you can see there is a 0 error because the distance between this metal, like polysilicon and this diffusion, right now you can see that it's a cross is kept. Wherever you are seeing such kind of cross, it means that there is a contact. There is a contact to the outer world. You can take it, you know. Actually, it's not the outer world, but it's still the metal one only. If you want to take something in metal one, I believe you understand what is metal 1, 2, 3, various metals are there. You can go from one metal to another metal, right? In case any doubt, you can ask me. Yeah. Srinivas, going fine? Okay. Yeah. Ashton and Rishiraj, till now fine. Okay. So this is body for NMOS. Similarly, I need to have body for PMOS, so I can make body for PMOS here, starting from this point to this point. And I'm going to keep the N substrate over there. It's there. And there is no error. Okay. You can save this because sometimes we need to save it. That's better. Yeah. So now, first of all, gate are connected because of polysilicon, but if I need to connect it to outer world, I'm not going to use directly polysilicon. I'm going to use some sort of metal to take it outside. If you want the metal, I need to go from polysilicon to metal one or metal two, whatever metal you have fallen, it has to be there. So I need one contact over here that will be poly contact. So let's assume that poly contact I need. I'm keeping it here. And I'm keeping poly contact. That contact is available. Note that just now we learn from this DRC error that it has to be like 4x4. That's why I'm keeping 4x4. If I'm going to keep it little bit smaller than that one, then this is going to give me an error. We can see here. Can you see? There is an error because it's not 4x4. So this is for your information that I'm keeping, right? So right now, this is actually at metal one. And if I want to draw maybe on top of this, I'm going to make something called metal one. I need to go to metal one. So metal one is here. So right now this is in metal one. So if outer world is available at metal eight, let's say, then you have to take this one to metal one, to two, two to three, three to four, and metal eight will be the outer world. Okay. Are you able to understand what do you mean by metal six, Danchu?
Yes, sir.
Right. So anywhere, if I want to take the output, it should be connected through the metal, and that metal is actually going to be connected to the pins, various pins of the various pins of the IC. Okay, so this is connected already, no problem. But now you should understand that, let's assume that this side of PMOS is source, and this side of NMOS is source. By the way, you can always interchange source and drain. There is no problem. However, for the easier side, we can have this one as source and this one is source, and both will be directly going to this body, which is going to be connected to one side. It will be ground, and other side it will be VDD. So here I need a contact which is going to connect this one. So this is right now, it's a P diffusion, and from P diffusion to some contact is required to go to metal one. So it will be PD contact, right? So P diffusion contact I'm going to make. So we understand that it has to be at least 4x4. It has to be 4x4. And it has to be PD contact. Okay. So right now this is also metal one, and this will be also metal one. So I can make one more connection going from here to here. So it will make the connection from this metal, this particular side of transistor to here. So I'm going to use the metal one. So now this is shorted. Source is connected. Similarly, if I want to connect this side of source, I'm going to use 4x4 at least. And I'm going, okay. 4x4, and I need to use something called PD contact. So it's giving an error. ND contact. Yes, ND contact. Okay, so now there is no error. And I can connect this one to, so metal is going from here to here, and it's going to connect. So both sources are connected to body. But now I need to connect both the drain together. So here also I need to take this diffusion layer to contact of metal one. So I'm going to make 4x4. And here I'm going to use ND contact, sorry, PD contact, right? And here again, at the same side, I'm going to use ND contact. Okay, and both has to be connected to a metal one, right? So I'm going to connect. So now you can see this is a layout for using Z and Shift Z. You can zoom in and zoom out. Okay. So right now, most of the things are there. The missing part is, what is the missing part, by the way? Output, input, VDD, ground, all these things needs to be written. So they have to be labeled. When you want to label it, yeah. What is it? Oh, I forgot to keep the envel, and it has to be in envel. Thank you. So I can make the connection from here to here, and I can keep something called envel. Right? But now it's in envel. So that's done from our side. This is PMOS, this is NMOS, and rest of the things are actually we need to give the net name. So here, if you want to do that, first of all, you have to make sure that the cursor where it is, it should not be box. Let's say here, it should look like this plus symbol. So plus symbol is possible when you are going to click the left click first here, and then same place if you are going to do the right click. So it will show the plus symbol only. And there I want to label it. So I'm going to use one command called label. Let's call this one as out. So out is available here. Similarly, I might be interested to call this one as ground. My suggestion is keep always these labels and all in capital. Okay. And here I want, it's a VDD. So whenever you want to label something, you are going to call that one as label VDD. Okay. And maybe other side, you can call this one as label in. So this is here. So this is the complete layout. You can save this. Okay. And thereafter, we can, because anything left?
We can create while saving, we can save and create a folder so that netlist will be in that folder.
Save as.
Okay, no problem.
Okay. So here I need to extract it, right?
Yes.
So there is something called extract. So there is a command extract and then all. If you do this, it will extract all the information for whatever the thing layout we made. And then there is something called ext2 spice. That's the command, because you want to see everything in a netlist form. Maybe most of the people now know what is netlist. Rishiraj, you know what is netlist? This is only one thing. Other thing, what about transistor? Okay, now you are going to see that. Okay, if you don't know, then so this is finished. Then okay, on desktop. Okay, where?
This layout was open in which folder?
I don't know. It's okay. Local user means home. CMOS 12. So CMOS 12 spice, that's the actually this CMOS 12 mag, that's the magic file. This is this one, and spice is the one which you have converted this layout to the netlist. So it's a spice netlist. Oh yes. Okay, me here the okay. So here you can see, first of all, there is a option is written, scale is 1 micro, then M1000 and M1001, one of them is NMOS and one of them is PMOS. Somebody can tell me which one is NMOS and which one is PMOS?
M1001 is NMOS.
Okay, how did you find out?
VDD and ground.
Okay, even it's written PFET.
Yeah.
So yeah, you are also right. There is PFET and NFET can be anything, but they have, like it has been identified that PFET has the dimension of width of 5 and length of 2. Okay. And this one is width of 4 and length of 2. So in this particular thing, you can see extra thing, which is called C0, which is between in and ground, whose capacitance is 5.10 femtofarad. That's the parasitic. If you have not drawn it, but this is also giving something called parasitic extracted value of capacitance also in this particular case. Okay, that will not be the case when you are going to make it in cadence. We have to run separate simulation for PEX, parasitic extraction. So this is what we have. Okay, so after this, because right now, whatever you made it, you are satisfied that this is a transistor and this is an inverter. So what my suggestion is, those who are at home, please make SRAM, DRAM and TCAM, all the layouts. Okay, whatever you did it for schematic, did it for, please do it for the layout and find out it's, the whole schematic SPICE file. But later on, we need to find out whether it's matching with what we were expecting or not. Right now, this is only layout, but in reality, you might have something called, schematic also, because sometimes schematic is more complicated and schematic needs to be matched with what layout you are making with. So right now, you know that it's inverter and it's a small circuit. That's why it's okay, fine. But it has to be automatically matched with some tool, right? So for our case, we are going to use some Mentor Graphics tools. But for the Magic users, we are going to use Magic as well as Simica. So what you can do, you can go to Simica, make one inverter with the dimensions which are given here. Use that and remove the capacitance. So just to match that, in Simica, you are not going to use capacitance, right? So remove that and then try to match whether it's matching or not. For that, there is something called, we are going to use one tool called NetGen. Okay, sudo is always required, right? So NetGen and enter. Okay, so here there is a new tool called NetGen, but right now do we have
we have a NetGrid generated from Simica.
Where is it?
It is in desktop, so okay. We will copy and paste over here.
Which one?
PLSI folder and .spc last.
So this one has been copied from Simica. Okay, so we are keeping at same place so that things will be pretty easy. Just if you want to see what is there, you can. Okay. Okay, so here you can see that this is generated by Simica. It's already written over here. Okay, and that is done by Rohit. So language is already written here. Then the parameters, and there are two transistors. So now, Rishiraj, you can see here, for transistor, there are, four terminals are there, right? One will be, first will be drain, gate, source, and body. And that is how it's written for NMOS and PMOS both. And thereafter, there has to be some name which reflects that it's NMOS or PMOS and it's reflecting the model. Okay. And these are the parameters, including the multipliers, which has been kept over here. Right. So now that file is already there. So what is the command for that? NetGen.
LVS.
Okay. LVS.
Then CMOS 1 2 batch
files. So CMOS 1 2, that's okay. So this is one which is generated by Magic, and another one is Netlist, which is taken by Simica. As per, what do you think? Will it match or not, Sudhanshu?
I don't know. Maybe it will match.
How it will match?
Because of capacitor.
No. Won't match. Okay, let's see. Do not match. Netlist do not match means, look, everything has to be matched. Width, capacitance, width, length, and everything has to be matched. So, if you look at this part, if you look at this one, it has width of something like 6 micro.
Okay, because of multiplier.
Multiplier is okay, fine, but multiplier, if in our case it's one, right? We can do this one. Let's say, let's make this one one. What was the dimension? So here you can see that this transistor is 5 and 2. PMOS has to be 5 and 2. Micrometer, by the way. Okay, units are micrometer. And we need to remove this one also. Okay. So this has been removed, first of all. 5 by 2 and 4 by 2. Here, 5 by 2. And 6 by 4 by 2. Okay, and I'm saving this. Now let's see what net. Okay, still do not match. This is fine. I haven't saved as yet.
This is fine. CMOS 1 2 dot spice.
This is CMOS 1 2 dot spice only, right?
This is from CMOS.
This one.
This is from here. It is edited, but still in that report it is showing that cap C, but it shows CMOS
okay.
1 2 dot spice contains three strings.
So it has only one.
Over here it is deleted, it should not show actually.
Maybe we can one more time. Sometimes restart will help. So here you can say circuits match uniquely. That is what we wanted. Okay. For those who are using Cadence, we are going to have green smiley when it's matching. So you don't need to read that. Anyway, so this is how you can make layout and you can also practice. So this is for